Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
God,
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 O God, who through the fruitful virginity of Blessed Mary bestowed on the human race the grace of eternal salvation, grant, we pray, that we may experience the intercession of her through whom we were found worthy to receive the author of life, our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
The shepherds went in haste to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that had been told to them about this child. All who heard it were amazed by what had been told to them by the shepherds. And Mary kept all things reflecting on them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as it had been told to them. When 8 days were completed for his circumcision, he was named Jesus, the name given to him by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Come, listen to me, my child, and I will teach you reverence for the Lord.
Now, with all my heart, I follow you. I reverence you and seek your presence. Lord, fulfill my hope. Show me your loving kindness, the greatness of your mercy. Consecrated to God in your life and our example
for us. The 1970 Prima Rotunda was the introduction to the rite of consecrated life, to the consecrated life of virginity, states the following requirements for women living in a world to receive this consecration. And it says that they have never married or live in open violation of chastity, that by their prudence and universally approved character, they give assurance of perseverance in a life of chastity dedicated to the service of the church and of their neighbor, that they be admitted to this consecration by the bishop, who is the local ordinary. That be me. Well, the ritual for the consecration of a virgin is one of the oldest sacramentals in the church. It went out of practice for some time, but was restored following the Second Vatican Council in 1970. Through this sacramental, the virgin, after making her promise of perpetual virginity to God, is set aside as a sacred person who belongs only to Christ. While it is the bishop who admits the woman, the consecration is to God, who accepts the virgin's promise and spiritually embraces her through the action of the Holy Spirit. While not a member of a particular religious congregation like the four of our sisters here, she becomes a consecrated woman who assumes a responsibility to pray for her diocese, and I would add the bishop, and to voluntarily serve the church in some capacity, mostly within her own parish. One element of the celebration that I think of first is that Amanda's consecration is that she is a religious woman. I already alluded to that. A person God has created and called to holiness. Being religious is a concrete response to a call from God. Being truly religious is more than merely doing religious things. The response to religion is about being a holy person, and is a calling that we all share. A woman who is baptized into Christ and whose fundamental identity is that of a daughter of God, a sister of the risen Lord, is a woman who strives to be holy. This is not the same thing as living a completely perfect life, for example, as was the Blessed Mother. We all happen to have our flaws. Some of us have more than others. I'm speaking about myself. But the response to God and the example of the Blessed Mother's fidelity is the model for all of us to embrace. When the Mother of God heard the message of the Archangel of God, she responded completely. Through her, the Word of God became flesh, and our hope of salvation was born. A second element that strikes me about a religious woman is how important she is for the church. Women who are baptized into Christ retain their femininity, which is essential for the body of Christ. It is only as male and female, after all, that we have a full sense of the fullness of our humanity. Both maleness and femaleness are essential for us to experience our shared identity as a people created in the image and likeness of God. A third element of being a consecrated virgin is the particular way in which some women have responded to the call of God in their lives and in their particular path to holiness. The life of a woman who is a consecrated virgin involves a special charism. A charism is a living life of grace in a certain way. The word itself means gift, in this case, a gift from God. As a gift from God, it is a vocation. And in a definite way, it is a vocation that witnesses powerfully in a world that need of message, but it's not praise at all. It is a witness for all of us. In the years to come, I ask God's blessing upon you, Amanda, so that you will provide a good and faithful witness to the people. By your consecration and your witness, You will teach a segment of God's people what it means to live a life in Christ. You do this even now for us today as we celebrate the Consecration, a foretaste of the fullness of life to which God calls us all. May the Mother of God intercede for you and for all of us as we begin this new year. Amanda, are you resolved to persevere to the end of your days in the holy state of virginity and in the service of God and His Church? Are you resolved to follow Christ with the Spirit of the Gospel, that your whole life may be a faithful witness to God's love and a convincing sign of the Kingdom of Heaven? Are you resolved to accept solemn consecration as a bride of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God? Thanks be to God. Dearly beloved, let us pray to God the Almighty Father, through His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, that by the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints, He will pour out the Holy Spirit of His love on this servant of His, whom He has chosen to be consecrated to His service. Amanda, you would be conscious. The rest of us remain standing.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
God, the Father of heaven,
have mercy on us.
God, the Son, Redeemer of the world,
have mercy on us.
God, the Holy Spirit,
have mercy on us.
Holy Mary,
pray for us.
Holy Mother of God,
pray for us.
Holy Virgin of Virgins,
pray for us.
Saint Michael,
pray for us.
Saint Gabriel,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael,
pray for us.
All you holy angels and archangels,
pray for us.
Saint John the Baptist,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
All you holy patriarchs and prophets,
pray for us.
Saint Mary Magdalene,
pray for us.
Saint Agatha,
pray for us.
Saint Lucy,
pray for us.
Saint Agnes,
pray for us.
Saint Cecilia,
pray for us.
Saint Anastasia,
pray for us.
Saint Catherine,
pray for us.
Saint Clare,
pray for us.
Saint Elizabeth,
pray for us.
Saint Faustina,
pray for us.
All you holy virgins and widows,
pray for us.
All you holy saints of God,
pray for us.
By the mystery of your holy incarnation, Lord, save your people.
Lord, save your people.
By your coming,
Lord, save your people.
By your birth,
Lord, save your people.
By your baptism and holy fasting,
Lord, save your people.
By your cross and passion,
Lord, save your people.
By your death and burial,
Lord, save your people.
By your holy resurrection,
Lord, save your people.
By your wonderful ascension,
Lord, save your people.
By the coming of the Holy Spirit,
Lord, save your people.
please you to bring us to true penance.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Guide and protect your holy church.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Preserve in holy religion the Pope and all those in the holy order.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Humble the enemies of the holy church.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Give peace and unity to the whole Christian people.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring back to the unity of the church all those who are straying, and bring all unbelievers to the light of the gospel.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Strengthen and preserve us in your holy service.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Raise our minds to desire the things of heaven.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Reward all our benefactors with eternal blessings.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Deliver our souls from the eternal damnation and the souls of our brethren and relatives and benefactors.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Give and preserve the fruits of the earth.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Grant eternal rest to all the faithful departed.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That it may please you to hear us and heed us, Jesus, Son, the living God.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world,
spare us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
graciously hear us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, hear the prayers of your church. Look with favor on your handmaid whom you have called in your love. Send her on the way to eternal salvation. May she seek only what is pleasing to you and fulfill it with watchful care. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Loving Father, the chaste bodies of your temple, you delight in sinless hearts. Our nature was corrupted when the devil deceived our first parents, but you have restored it in Christ. He is your word through whom all things were made. He has made our nature whole again and made it possible for mortal people to reflect the life of angels. Lord, look with favor on your handmaid. She places in your hands her resolve to live in chastity. You prompt her in this, her intention. Now she gives you her heart. Only you can kindle this flame of love and feed its brightness, giving strength and perseverance to our will. Without you, our flesh is weak, bound by the law of nature. Free with false freedom, imprisoned by habit, softened by the spirit of the age. You have poured out your grace upon all peoples. You have adopted as heirs of a new covenant, sons and daughters from every nation under heaven, countless as the stars, Your children are born not of human birth or of man's desire, but of your spirit. Among your many gifts, you give to some the grace of virginity. Yet the honor of marriage is in no way lessened. As it was in the beginning, your first blessing still remains upon this holy union. Yet your loving wisdom chooses those who make sacrifice of marriage for the sake of the love of which it is the sign. They renounce the joys of human marriage, but cherish all that it foreshadows. Those who choose chastity have looked upon the face of Christ, its origin and inspiration. They give themselves wholly to Christ, the Son of the ever-Virgin Mary, and the heavenly bridegroom of those in whom, who in his honor dedicate themselves to lasting virginity. Lord, protect she who seeks your help. She desires to be strengthened by your blessing and consecration. Defend her from the cunning and deceit of the enemy. Keep her vigilant and on her guard. May nothing tarnish the glory of her virginity or the vocation of purity which is shared by those who are married. Through the gift of your Spirit, Lord, give her modesty with right judgment, kindness with true wisdom, gentleness with strength of character, freedom with the grace of chastity. Give her the warmth of love, to love you above all others. Make her life deserve our praise without seeking to be praised. May she give you glory by holiness of action and purity of heart. May she love you and fear you. May she love you and serve you. Be yourself her glory, her joy, her whole desire. Be her comfort in sorrow, her wisdom in perplexity, her protection in the midst of injustice, her patience in adversity, her riches in poverty, her food in fasting, her remedy in time of sickness. She has chosen you above all things. May she find all things in possessing you. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Dearest daughter of Adam, receive the veil and the ring that are the insignia of your consecration. Keep unstained your fidelity to your bridegroom, and never forget that you are bound to the service of Christ and of his body, the Church. Receive the book of the Liturgy of the Hours, the prayer of the Church. May the praise of our Heavenly Father be always on your lips. Pray without ceasing for the salvation of the whole world. Don't forget to pray for your bishop.
Thank you.
8.
May the Almighty Father, by his protection, keep intact the resolve he has poured into your heart to live in blessed virginity.
Amen.
May the Lord Jesus, who unites himself in the hearts of sacred virgins in a nuptial covenant, make your heart fruitful by the word that is God's seed.
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit, who came down upon the Blessed Virgin and descending today upon you, has consecrated your heart, and he fired you with zeal for the service of God and the Church.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here for these sacred rites, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Number 7, 8. Joy to the world. Number 7, 8.